نحمد ونصلي على رسوله الكريم اما بعد فاعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي The book of Zakat كتاب الزكاه part 2 english قالوا يا ويلنا انا كنا طاغين This is in surah number 68 and Ayah number 31. They said, Alas for us, we have indeed transgressed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala declares thus, فَذَلِكَ الْعَذَابُ وَالْعَذَابَ الْآخِرَةَ أَكْبَرُ لَوْ كَانُوا يَعْلَمُونَ This is in surah number 68, verse number, ayah number 33. Such is the punishment in the life, but greater is the punishment in the hereafter, if only they know. From the above mentioned example in the Quran, it is not at all difficult to appreciate as to how trying is wealth for a man. So if we look around, it is not uncommon to notice so many people are running their faith and fidelity in the worldly life simply due to the greed for wealth. So this love for wealth creates in man such a vile and mean instinct as miserliness and selfishness and hard-heartedness and arrogance, which in turn involves him in sins like falsehood, deceit, cruelty and depriving of one of the rights. All this causes great disorder and destruction in this world and the hereafter is the lost too. So these are the Quranic verses I was referring to, and there is one more verse from Surah number 59 and ayat number 9 وَيُورِسُونَ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ وَلَوْ كَانَ بِهِمْ خَسَاسَ But give them preference over themselves even though poverty was their own a lot. An incident reported in Mustadrak Hakim is also worthy of note. A companion of Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam received a gift, the head of a sheep. Thinking that another person needed that head more than himself, he passed it on to him. The second one, for the same reason, sent it to the third. This way, after going around seven houses, the sheep head came back to the first companion. During the early Islamic society, such instances of mutual help, respect and sympathy are plenty, which was natural outcome of people's resolve to spend and act according to Allah's command. So here we'll see a few more ayahs and then we'll start with the hadith inshallah. مَسَلُ الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ أَمْوَالَهُمْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ كَمَسَلِ الْحَبَّةٍ أَنْبَتُوا سَبَعَ سَنَابِيلَ فِي كُلُّ سُنْبُلَةٍ مِئَةَ حَبَّ وَاللَّهُ يُدَعِفُ لِمَنْ يَشَى وَاللَّهُ وَاسِيٌ عَلِيمٌ Surah Al-Baqarah, ayah number 261. The parable of those who spend their substance in the way of Allah is that of a grain of corn. It grows 7 years and each year hath 100 grains. Allah give manifold increase to whom He pleased and Allah cares for all He knows and all things. Like Allah can increase yudaifu, it can be multifold, double or more than that. So in تُقْرِضُوا اللَّهَ قَرْضًا حَسَنًا يُضَاعِفُ لَكُمْ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ شَكُورٌ حَلِيمٌ This is in Surah number 64 and Ayat number 17. If you loan Allah a beautiful loan, He will double it to your credit and He will grant you forgiveness. For Allah is most ready in appreciate service, most forbearing. So we have seen the ayahs of the Quran. And after that, inshallah, now we're going to start the hadith chapter. And the first chapter in this is Fardiyatul Zakat, obligatory nature of Zakat. Zakat is one of the five basic divine commands. Abdullah bin Umar radiallahu anha says, the messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam described the following as five pillars. First, Shahada, La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. And then second, to establish Salah. Third one is to pay Zakat. The fourth is to perform Hajj. And fifth is to fast in the month of Ramadan. This is in Bukhari. And Abi Umar radiallahu anhuma, Qala qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Bunyanu Islama ala qamsin. It's on five. First, Shahadati anna la ilaha illallahu wa anna Muhammadur Rasulullah. Wa aqimu salata. Second, wa itai zakat. Wal hajja wa sawma Ramadan. The next hadith, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam took an oath of an allegiance for paying the zakat. Jarir bin Abdullah radiallahu anha relates that Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam took a covenant from him to establish prayer, to pay zakat, and to strive for the well-being of Muslims. It is right to wage a holy war against those who refuse to pay zakat. Zakat has been ranked with obligatory prayers and it cannot be substituted by any charity or anything or any tax. You know, you are thinking, okay, I am paying tax yearly, so I am not going to pay zakat. No, you can't exempt from that. It is stated by Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu that on the death of Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu became Khalifa, now he is Khalifa, some of the Arabs became apostate and refused to pay zakat. They said they are not going to pay zakat. Umar radiallahu anhu said, how can you wage a holy war against them when Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has declared that he would fight until they acknowledge that there was no God but Allah, like La ilaha illallah. After that, had no quarrel with them and rest of the matters lay with Allah. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu was not satisfied and said, by Wallahi, whoever makes a distinction between prayers and zakat, I will fight against him. So he said, I will fight against him. If you own wealth, you owe zakat. Means whoever is having wealth, they have to pay the zakat. Even if they withhold a small lamp, which they were giving as zakat to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I will fight. Umar radiallahu anhu remarked, God has given Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu true insight and I instantly realized that he was right. This is in Bukhari. The next chapter, Fadlu Zakat, Excellence of Zakat. One who pays zakat is sure to get into paradise. That is Jannah. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu relates that an Arab gentleman requested Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to teach him in such a course of action which should ultimately enable him to enter Jannah. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam replied, worship Allah and do not join anyone else, you know, believing in one Allah and not doing shirk. The second is establish regular salah. Give obligatory zakat and observe the fast in the month of Ramadan. The man said, by Allah, I shall do in no more, no less. When the man was leaving, Messenger of Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam pointed out and said, if you want to see a person who is destined for Jannah, look at this person. This is in Bukhari. An Abu Huraira radiallah an Arabi ya Ata Nabiya Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Like, you know, he came to Ata Yuti, he came to Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. فَقَالَ دُلْنِي عَلَىٰ عَمَلِ إِذَا عَمَلَتْهُ دَقَلْتُ جَنَّةً. He said, which are the amal which can make you enter دَقَلْتُ, enter Jannah. قَالَ تَعْبُدُ اللَّهِ لَا تُشْرِكُ بِهِ شَيَّا. Don't do any shirk. Then, وَتُقِيمُ السَّلَاةِ. Then, establish salat. And then, afterward, تُو زَكَى and Makhruda wa tusumul Ramadan, and also fast in the Ramadan. And after that, you know, qala allazi nafsi biyadihil, and he said, wallahi, I will do all this what you have mentioned, not more, not less. And when he was going, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, look at this person, he will be going to Jannah because of this, like whatever the thing he said, he is going to do it. Once who pays zakat is a man of faith and right belief. Abu Musa Abu Malik Al-Ashari radiallahu anhu reports that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, making of ablution to false satisfaction amount to half of the faith. To utter Alhamdulillah all the praises to Allah, fill the scale with virtues, to utter Subhanallah, glorifies be Allah, and Allahu Akbar, Allah is the greatest, fill the whole universe with virtues, pray will serve as torch light on the day of resurrection, paying the zakat, due zakat will serve as a guide, patience over the troubles and hardships is a light, the Quran will plead either for you or against you on the day of resurrection. So here this hadith an Abu Malik al-Ashari anna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qala isbaghu al-wudu'u shatra al-shatra al-iman, you know, doing wudu completely nicely is half of the iman. Then walhamdulillahi tumalul mizan, it will fill the mizan. An tasbihu takbir, you know, saying tasbih takbir, Allahu Akbar, that yamla'u, it will fill the as-samawat, the sky, wal ard, and also the sky. Wassalatu nurin, like, you know, when you pray, like, it's like a torch light on the day of resurrection. And zakatu burhan, and zakat will serve as a burhan, is guide. And was sabru siyan, and here patience over the troubles. Sabru is sabr, patience. Siyan is like, you know, when you have any trouble or hardship. Wal Quran hujjatun laka aw alayka, means Quran will be either for you or against you. What does it mean? Like, when you read Quran, it will intercede, it will favor you. But we do, when we don't read Quran, when we don't act upon it, and, you know, we're going to keep on the top shelf, and so that we never reach there, and we are not going to read, and we never practice it, then it will be against you. This is transmitted in Nisai. Khalid bin Aslam radiallahu anhu says, we sent out to somewhere with Abdullah bin Umar radiallahu anhu. On our way, a villager said to us, please explain to me the verse, those who hoard gold and silver and do not spend in the way of Allah, at Surah At-Tawbah 34. Abdullah bin Umar radiallahu anhu said, woe unto the who heads gold and wealth but does not pay the due zakat. And this verse was revealed before the order of zakat. When zakat became obligatory, Allah purified wealth through it. You know, this is before the hukum came. So, and after that, you know, they have to pay the zakat, that is obligatory. And next chapter, inshallah, we'll see that. Ahmiyatu zakat, importance of zakat. Gold and silver on which zakat is not paid will be turned into metal plates on the day of judgment. And the owner will be branded on the forehead, on the back, and on the thighs. Animal on which zakat is not paid will trample on the day of judgment under their feet, the owner, for 50,000 years. It's longer hadith. Abu Huraira radiallahu anha reports that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, one who possesses gold or silver does not pay the zakat on the day of resurrection, plates will be made of that gold or silver, heated in the fire of hell, and with this plate, his forehead, his sides, his back will be stigmatized. Whenever these plates will put in the fire, they will be brought back to torture them. This punishment will be meted out to him for the whole day, whose duration will be 50,000 years, till the case of all human beings will be decided. You know, because they didn't pay, so they are branded with those. And it is like 50,000 years till the case of all human beings will be decided. You know, other cases are decided. Then he will find his way either to Jannah or to Jahannam, that is hellfire. The people said, O Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what about the camels? They asked about the camel. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, he who possesses camels and does not pay zakat, and it is also the part of dew, that the day he waters the camel, he should milk it and give the milk to the poor according to the custom. He will be laid in an even field with his face downward, and those camel will come with fat and healthy bodies. Not even a child will remain behind, and they will trample him. No, this camel will trample him with their feet and hit him with their teeth. Then a camel, after trampling him, will go back, and other will come and repeat the same action. This procedure will continue the whole day, whose duration will be 50,000 years. Then he will find his way either to Jannah or Jahannam. The people said, O Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, what about cows and sheep? Now they ask, what about cows and sheep? Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, who possess cows and sheep and does not pay zakat will laid his face downward. Then the cows and sheep will come with their sharp pointed horns, and none being without horns or blunt horns or broken horns. You know, they have large horns. They will poke him with their horns and trample him with the hoofs. The process will continue the whole day, whose duration will be 15,000 years, till the case of all human beings are decided. Then he will find his way either to Jannah or Jahannam. So here we learn three things. First, when somebody is not paying on gold or silver, they will be branded with those on their foreheads, back, okay, on the day of judgment. And it will be going on till the matter is decided, other people are in the procedure. But the second thing was, who is not giving zakat on camel, and they will be trampling with their feet and with the teeth. And the third thing we have seen is about the cows and sheep. If they are not paying zakat on that, they are trampling, and the duration will be 15,000 years till the case of all human beings are decided. And this was mentioned in Muslim, the above hadith. And Ahnaf bin Qais radiallahu anhu says, I was sitting among some people of Quraysh when Abu Zar radiallahu anhu came and said, warn those who heap wealth of the scar which will be inflicted on their backs and pierced through their sides. You know, if they are holding that thing, it will be pierced on their back, then on the napes of the necks, and pierced through their foreheads. Then Abu Zar radiallahu anhu says, on a side, I asked people about who he was. The people told me he was Abu Zar. So I went to him and asked, what was that which I heard from you just now? He said, I just said which I have heard from the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is in Muslim. Rest will continue in the next.